It is a little gloomy outside, but you know, that's just kind of weather trick-or-treaters like, right? This is live from our Effort of Sky Cam. That overcast, tough to get rid of today. And as a result of the overcast and the easterly breeze, temperatures have not changed very much. We're still running in the low 60s all around the valley, 61 showing up in a number of spots, 62. Warmest spots, Gettysburg and Chambersburg, where the clouds have thinned a little bit. They're in the mid-60s right now. So as we go through the evening hours, don't look for much in the way of change. It'll stay cloudy. It's going to be kind of damp and cool. 58 to 65 for temperatures. Overnight tonight, we'll likely start to see a little more drizzle develop, and we'll have some patchy fog too, with low temperatures at 54 to 58. Then for the day tomorrow, clouds and fog to start the day off, but in the afternoon, the high pressure that's been forcing this moisture in off the Atlantic will start to move away a little bit, and so a better chance tomorrow that skies will brighten up a little bit during the second half of the day. Here's a satellite view, and you can see where we sit compared to our neighbors. It is sunny, full sun in western Pennsylvania. When you get to Washington, D.C. now, it's clearing out nicely there. The Poconos are right on the edge of the clouds, and right here in the Susquehanna Valley, we are just trapped under this. It's an interesting phenomenon. It's caused by this easterly breeze. The breeze brings the moisture and the cool air in off the ocean. The mountains are right here to block that, and so in the valley, and we literally are in one, this all just kind of gets trapped and backed up, and so that's what we see. Overnight tonight, you can see how that kind of expands once again and lingers into tomorrow morning. This is 8:30 Friday morning. Then, as I said, the winds start to shift a little bit, so skies may brighten a little bit. Looks like it should be dry for Football Friday tomorrow night. Still some lingering clouds around. Then we have a front that's on our doorstep on Saturday. It's likely this front will really slow down as a result of Sandy making her way up the eastern seaboard. So we'll keep an eye on that, but regardless, may bring us some rain showers by Sunday. And then, of course, Sandy may get into the mix as well. The latest 5 o'clock stats on Sandy. Now past Cuba, into the Bahamas, winds are 105 miles an hour, movements to the north at 20 miles per hour. Coming up on News 8 at 5:30, in just a few minutes from now, we'll have the latest. And as an aside, if you'd hope to do a little leaf peeking, this weekend, Saturday, would be the day. I mean, it's the driest day of the weekend, and if Sandy does, in fact, come into play here, which it looks like she may, there may not be much color left once she is done with us. So here's our seven-day forecast. Some a.m. fog tomorrow, then some sunshine brighter in the afternoon. Then, of course, the effects of Sandy could be felt here as early as Sunday, but most likely the brunt of it Monday and Tuesday, depending upon the track of the storm.